Deductive reasoning, like inductive reasoning, is something that you do every day, except it's the complete opposite. In deductive reasoning, you use general statements to help you make a specific logical conclusion. So, let's look at an example.
Good. So, how do we tell whether she is made of wood?
Build a bridge out of her.
Ah, but can you not also make bridges out of stone?
Oh, yeah.
Does a wood sink in water?
Oh, no, it floats. It floats over into the pond.
What also floats in water?
Alright, let's recap that interesting yet comical piece of deductive reasoning you just watched. Now, before I go on, know that no witches or innocent people were harmed in the filming of that movie, Monty Python and the Holy Grail. If you've never seen it, I suggest you check it out. Now, let's recap. The first statement that was made was that all witches are made of wood. Then, all wood floats, all ducks float, and all things that weigh the same will either both sink or float. So here were the four generalizations that led to the conclusion that that woman was a witch. Because since that poor woman weighed the same as a witch, then she must have been a witch. Now, that's an excellent example of logical deductive reasoning, but leading to an untrue example. It is possible to come to a logical conclusion that is untrue if the generalizations are not true. So here's another example of that. In the previous example, obviously the generalizations that were not true were that witches are not made of wood, and just because you weigh the same thing doesn't mean that you will both necessarily sink or float. Here is a simpler example. So, in this syllogism, we have that all teachers are bald, So that's the generalization. Mr. Scevola is a teacher, so therefore, Mr. Scevola is bald. Now, I am Mr. Scevola, and at the filming of this video, I am not bald. So that is an untrue conclusion, but there is nothing logically wrong with this syllogism, except that the generalization is false. So here's an example of a logical deduction. It's just a nice way of saying deductive reasoning. That is true. So first is the generalization. All angles between 90 and 180 degrees are obtuse. It's a generalization because it's talking about all the angles between 90 and 180 degrees. Now let's say I have one specific angle, angle Q, and that's 120 degrees. Then I can come to the conclusion that that angle Q is obtuse. So again, that's a good example of deductive reasoning because it started with a general statement and then went to prove something specific about one angle Q. Quickly, I want to talk about the differences between inductive and deductive reasoning. So earlier, we talked about inductive reasoning, and that's when you use specific examples to make a generalization. So you're looking for a pattern and trying to use that pattern to help you make a prediction about what comes next. Inductive reasoning is used to make discoveries and conjectures. So a scientist might use inductive reasoning to discover some new, maybe, vaccine. Now, to prove that that vaccine actually works, he needs to use deductive reasoning. So the scientific method is a good example of that. So remember, deductive reasoning is the opposite. It's using generalizations to make a specific conclusion, and it's used to prove conjectures. Thank you for watching the video, and have a good one.